Okay, hi guys. I'm Dev Ramsey. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be designing a landing page for movie seat booking site. That's part of my doing a course on the server by Google. UX research design, some is part of the project I'm supposed to do. Yeah, so you're going to be actually create a landing page. Yeah, so welcome once again. So just putting in the title of the screen, what I'm going to do, you know, this information about the landing page. Yeah. So I have some music playing in the background. That's a bit of rock and roll for you music heads out there. You can't just play without anything. Yeah. Not good. I'm a front end developer. Usually design then code. So yeah. I'm just checking to see if my navigation section fits the grid width I like. So I use square grid to check that out. You can use the column if you want, but I personally prefer, for this section, I prefer using the squares. So then preview it on a screen. I see, okay, it's a bit big. Can make it a little small. I'm going to make some space for the announcement area. So landing page will have essentially five sections. Haven't decided yet. So there'll be the announcements area, the navigation bar, a banner image section, then a preview section for the movies. And lastly, a footer section, which has a subsection of the copyright area. Yeah, so just laying out the how the sections will look like. Banner. I have problems with spelling, so don't judge. I'm used to using Grammarly and autocorrect. Shaking cold, these hands are meant to hold. Thank you, man. When all you gotta give, that's the nerve. The navigation section, the announcement section. So guys, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe to the channel. I'm sorry the video is so long, but yeah, I need the watch hours to monitor it, but trust me, it's worth it. So this is just part one of the video series. I'll be creating more pages for the movie seat reservation web app. that from, I'll create the about set, about page, and create the contact page. After you log in and create the pages where you reserve your seats. So that's in part, the following parts. So from part two, this is just a landing page. When all you gotta keep is strong, move along like I know you do. And even when your hope is gone. So I normally don't work on one screen. I like to separate my screens so that I can see there's some progress in my work. I'm sure most of you feel that too. So here I'm using the column grid so that I can do space the logo correctly, like leaving the, yeah, like place it right there. Do the same for the sign in button. So guys, you can check out my Behance for more design inspirations. I'm on Behance, I'm on Dribbble. So I have a portfolio website, you can check my bio. Is that something? The bio on YouTube, I'm sure. So yeah. So we have the sections outlined very well. I'm going to make another screen so that now we can start the real design in now. So I packed my things and ran far away from all the trouble. I cast with my. So what should we name our movie site? Movie Flix? That's. Is that okay with you guys? So apparently they are not good fonts on Adobe XD. I like to download my fonts. So guys, allow me to just go to the name of this site, Google Fonts. Get some fonts, some good looking fonts, man. Yeah, so normally I just check out the fonts, how they look. But I see something looking good, I go ahead with it. But yeah, let's see. This one looks interesting. Yeah, very nice, very nice. So let's download this. So a bonus, what do you call it? A bonus. I'm going to show you guys how to upload a font onto Adobe XD. I'll do a separate video also, but yeah. Guys have the luxury of lack of see me do it here live. Yeah, thank you guys for joining the stream. Yeah, so this is how you do it. You just have to go to your Google Creative Cloud app. My internet's a bit slow. So you navigate to the font section. So I forgot how to do it, and yeah. is me googling how to do it. One thing with Google nowadays, you can't get the right answer. There's so much information out there. Most of the time, I improvise. I just wing it. And this doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense at all. Okay. Let's see. Okay. How to install fonts on Mac and Windows. Let's see these guys. Let's see. So if guys you like the video, don't forget to like a comment. So apparently this is documentation for Windows 7. Yeah, if you like this type of content by just chilling, listening to music as you leave a comment, I'll do more of this. Again, I'm sorry it's so long. Trust me, it's a lot of information from not just designing to assets, finding colors, finding fonts, so we found it here. Yeah, it's under Creative Cloud, then fonts. Let's see. Yeah, drag and drop files, I mean font. So remember we downloaded the font. See, yeah, here it is. And we have to extract it. How do WinRAR make their money? Because I've been using it for free for the longest time. You guys know. Because I've been extracting files from as long as I can remember using this application, but I've never paid for it. So they just created a software for free. How good. Okay, let's import the fonts. Going to select all of them. Yeah, let's add one more. Yeah, looks good. Let's save and see. Has the internet gotten slower this year? Or is it just these are taking forever. Let's just go back to XD and see if some of them made it. So it was F, far. Just see F. Yeah, it is. Yeah, very nice looking font. Doesn't shine. It looks good. I should be over. color is not bad. But I'm looking for a darker background. So essentially the landing page will have like a dark theme to it. Let's look for colors. Let's use in auto 255 so I get my color palette. auto255.com, so you get a large selection of colors. So let's see, you get the hex codes, you can get any type of output you want from hex to RGB. So let's see what color is. So I'm going to put more links later on. So for now, let's just have home here. I'm going to change the font to that name and spell it and pronounce it. But you can never go wrong with that font for your general boot or text, like normal text, not headings. I never go wrong with that font. Let's look for another color. Next time I look for hip hop, but I like alternative rock music, not like metal, but just soft rock, the punk rock, like Paramore, Linkin Park, The Fray. So how many guys are rock? Do you want a link to the playlist? Can you give me a link to the playlist from Spotify? We are 19 minutes in. The design is still looking a bit far off. I trust the guys, it's going to be something. So while I'm designing, I try to keep in mind that at the end of the day, there's going to be a programmer trying to improve what I'm designing. So I don't try to be out there as much as I would want to be. Like to design a short battle at internet. I look so out of this world, but at the end of the day, your design stays as a design. It's not really like why it's like painting a masterpiece and putting it under the bed. So designers try to design what developers can develop. So you guys have seen that new designer listening to music 3 AM doing some dark mode animation. Yeah, that's me right now. When I group my elements, I like to do the padding, and also not just the padding, but also do the direction, stack. So how my elements stacked, that helps me when it comes to moving items around the place. So I'm able to maintain my margins, maintain my party. Yeah. I got your picture, I'm coming with you, dear Maria, come in. There's a story at the bottom of this bottle and on the pen. Go up, I wanna watch the way you take the stage by storm. The way you wrap those boys around your finger. Go on and play the leader, cause you know it's what you're good at. The low road for the fast track, make every second. Guys, remember to leave a comment if you enjoy it. Give a like. I'm also going to leave links to my Behance and Dribbble on the description. So check out my other designs. I think the narrative is looking good. Let's move on to the banner section. So remember, this is a movie seat reservation app. So our images are supposed to be, in that type of space. So I'm going to speed up this section so that I don't bore you with how I find my assets. But yeah, I usually use Unsplash, Pixels, so now I'm using Unsplash. That image looks good. So let's add it to our design. Banner image section. Yeah. We have a banner image. Let's apply the font, special font to our text here. You guys know some interesting shortcuts that are helpful next week. So you can leave a comment of the specific shortcuts.
in the color. It's a nice image of a movie theater right now. Hey guys, enjoy watching movies. Some really interesting films coming out this year. I think a while back I watched the trailer for Oppenheimer. I can't wait for that movie. Also, the review show How the Dragon is supposed to come out this month, May. They had something about a strike in guys, the writer. They're on strike or something. So if you're going to do an overlay here, that it can shade the section. We want to have a dark overlay to the image so that our text pop out. So I'm going to duplicate the image, then do a red fill, dark red fill, then adjust the opacity so that you can see the overlay. That will help our text pop. Let me center it quickly. Center. Don't worry, guys, I'm going to do some touch ups for the sections. I'm not going to leave them like this. I'm going to do a touch up before we end the video. I'm just doing a basic provision to this. Yeah. So now you guys are wondering if I'm going to monetize this video now. Obviously, I can't, it has too many copyrighted music in it. Yeah, keep the chat alive. When all of your flaws and all of my flaws are laid out one by one. Wonderful part of the mess that we made, we pick ourselves undone. All of your flaws and all. I'm going to add a section here between the banner section and the section. So here's where we're going to display a preview of the films that we can reserve seats for in our application. So I'm going to add How many cards? Six. Let me add 5 cards. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Cards are enough. We'll see that we need them to be who we are without. For this I use Alt Shift, then I drag using my mouse. So we're going to give the illusion that these cards are in a stack. They're shrinking as they are farther away from the cupboard or something. Yeah, so to do that we have to shrink the cards. Yeah, and also shrink the other one to smaller than the previous. Yeah. That's how you can keep it with them that
cards are growing to fun. So I'm just going to delete the others, then I'm going to get the one so that I don't have to guess the size. Yeah, delete that one and delete the other one. So we have delete that one too. Size, just the size of that card, yeah, so that it fits inside, so it doesn't look like it's cut off from the outside. Then I'm going to duplicate it, drag it to the other side so that it has uniformity. So this section I'm going to put, what do you call it, I'm going to put movie posters for upcoming shows. Yeah, I'm going to feature Oppenheimer, to look for maybe Extraction chapter 2. Yeah, which other movie do you guys like? Yeah, someone commented Spider-Man. Yeah, that looks nice. Let's do a drop shadow for the cards. Let them look like they have a neon tip. Yeah, so allow me to quickly accelerate here. I'm going to switch the posters. Second is taking life, let me just clear just the images. Yeah, it looks better already. Let's preview. Yeah, very nice, very nice. So the shrinking of the cards made all the difference for that section, definitely. So imagine if all were the same size, it look boring. So let's do progress path. I'm going to design them myself. Play progress paths. It looks better for progress. So that's Alt, Shift, Alt, and let's compress the width so that it makes a circle. So if you can't look at the circle, just compress the width. So that it has 15 by 15. loops. So let's do Mobile Brothers. So that's kind of a character. Awesome can press buttons to move within the character. Copy it and protect it so that we have a perfect mirror of it on the other side. Let's do that. So let's rotate. No, 180 degrees again. You can use the angle, the rotation angle. Yes, have it. Then,
it's been a long time coming since I seen your face. I've been everywhere and back trying to replace everything that I had till my feet went numb. Praying like a fool that's been on the run. Heart still beating but it's not working. It's like a $1 million phone.
So last but not least, you mentioned this section.
Yeah, my heart is numb.
The section will have the bulk section, the spinning section, other length section, social length section, those are enough. This section will right will be again use the column to go to your section. We are 39 minutes in. Let's enter it and open the screen out. That's good. Here we're going to do the logo and a small font. So I'm thinking of putting an image for this section in the background, but for now let's just do the color. Yeah, but we'll put an image for the complete Those are the touch-ups I'm talking about. So such landing pages don't really need a lot. It's just your service offering is very self-explanatory. You don't have to do a lot, set the body so that you convince someone to reserve a seat. You just have to show them that you can do this on our site, and this is what you can reserve a seat for. I'm going to look for an image that I've put on that section. Probably an image that's all dark. This one looks good. Yeah, that one looks good. Let me download this one. Yeah, again, I'm saying it's a SaaS. So the things you don't want to overwhelm a visitor with. Much information, so be straight to the point. Yeah, perfect. Looks really, really nice. It's when it gets to what the settings. Yeah. So I'm thinking there are sections I'm going to do. The bot section is going to look like credits. So you know how when a movie ends, you see the credits come up. I'm going to do something similar for the about section. So, I'm not sure how I'm going to design it, but it will have that feel of credits to it. I'm thinking of integrating other design elements, for example, a film, you know, the film tips, the old film tips, ones that had film, like a tangible film. So I'm going to integrate that into a design, maybe a carousel. So, because it is moving, then you have like a smooth transition, so that it looks like a carousel, like a movie reel. I'm not sure you're getting me there, but you get what I'm saying. Then you leave a comment. Design, you see, I don't know how to spell anything. Someone is asking where I'm located. I'm in Nairobi, Kenya. Yeah, I'm a designer, front end developer, based in Nairobi, Kenya. If you're a Kenyan and you're watching this, I leave a like, leave a comment. Don't forget to check out my Behance, my Dribbble, my portfolio website. If you want to hire me, I'm going to jobs. I'm broke, man. So hold my hand, I walk with you, my dear. So I'm going to remove this grid. It's the house telling you to close your eyes. Yes, I hope you're learning. I'm not doing anything new. I hope at least you're getting inspiration for the next flight. I haven't used a lot of layer now. Yeah, but let's fix it for the first design. Remember, if you design the design can't be built, it's not. It will forever be just a design. I don't know. Maybe I'm just hating. But yeah. I think as a, because I started my journey as a have given weird looking designs for me to implement, weren't easy. But yeah. Let's design. But with AI now, anything is possible. So don't listen to it. You do. Yes, you do. Again, I'm going to leave the link to the Spotify playlist in the description. Guys, you like this kind of music? Yeah, thank you. So we have useful legs, other legs. So we do super legs. Yeah. So guys, I get my plugin from Creative Cloud. One of the plugins I like using is icons. It's called, I don't know what it's called, but I use it to get my icon. Yeah, it's like a top steaming, spinning top or something. But if you just search for icons, it found a account that plugin. I also use another plugin. I'm not really a plugins fan, but also the thing I want to get at is the plugins. But I went back and stumbled upon all these plugins. Anyway, that can turn your design into HTML CSS. But you have to do a lot of design. It's easier to code for me, at least, easier to code than use the plugin. Yeah, it's a really good plugin. You don't know how to code that. You want your designs to turn your designs into code. Sponsor on your man. I'm glad you're doing this. Though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our body safe to shore. So we're 48 minutes in, guys. We're almost there. Just a little. I hope you're enjoying the music at least. I know my voice is terrible. But yeah. Gonna make it bend and break. Say a prayer, but let the good times roll. In case God doesn't show. This is. And I want these words to make things right. But it's the wrongs that make the words come to life. But who does he think he is? If that's the worst you got, better put your fingers back to the key. Social, your Facebook, Instagram, your Reddit, your TikTok, social. The language is it's like it's more or less done, just a few touch ups, and yeah, you can wrap up this session. So, thanks guys for joining the stream. Joining the live session, you know. It's a long session, but yeah. It's designed together. So I'm going to add long text. You know, I'm adding long text, I like create what's called a text area rather than just starting to write and having to use the script button. when you create a text area, the border, the right border, that's where your text is going to output, okay? And into the next line, so you can do the no line alone. So, the rest of the sections are just a matter of editing the colors and making sure that they're okay. So you're going to add the copyright section. You normally see this in most websites that they have all rights reserved, copyright. So that's it. What else am I going to do? I need to send out a text after. Yeah, so let's center the text. Centered, what? So it looks good. What else is left? Let's do the navigation bar and the announcements. So for that section, I'm going to quickly edit the button. After the button, I'm going to do. Let's remove the shadow because first I'm put the button. Boys and girls in the click, the names at the stick, you're never gonna fit. Let's remove the drop shadow. What you got under your shirt will make them pay for the things that they did. They said, so who's watching Oppenheimer with you? Let's be about all of the links for the navigation section. 18 is a good size. Let's make the component so that it's easier to edit across the board. So we're going to group all of them and stack them together. So we stack them, we can have one, the gap can be equal. So we stack them, we do the gap. And then you can now change each link to give it a special name character. So this is the theater. Then you have movies. So you'll see that the space is adjusting itself as we do this. That's because you stack it. So the direction is stuck there. Cards, the gap will always be the same. So let's add another one. Let's do a blog. We're going to design a blog for it too. Let's see. These videos are going to be center it. It's good. So another thing, when you copy, let's say you copy text that text has a particular styling, you can copy the text and paste the appearance, not the for example, let me select all of these, then I'll paste the appearance of that. Checking the color of the navbar, so I'm going to paste the appearance. Just appearance. So we're almost done with this. We've done that section. That's about what's left. Let's just finish up with the announcement section. After we're done with the announcement section, we can call it. What do we do? Free tickets for anyone who can name people starring in the animation, the Spider-Man across the multiverse. Yeah. That seems like a fair announcement. Price for tickets. First 50 participants will get free tickets. Which is a lot, but just a design. A lot. So these kinds of rewards, let's say you are a business and you're looking for such a website, giving such rewards will help you grow your business in terms of people interacting with your site. So if they get their free tickets, they will log to your website and get a ticket. That means that you get more coverage, who will always be looking out for the next offer. Yeah. Yeah, just a business tip for those business people out there. So let's just center this. Yeah, so we center it. I think we can reduce the size and we'll keep that. So. Here's the thing, we started one across the world. Thinking of doing a podcast while I'm designing. So are you guys interested in such an endeavor? I can be doing the podcast while I'm streaming the design session, then we can talk about the current events, the world, doesn't have to be Kenya. Are you guys again? Instead of just playing non-stop music, we can mix it up with some talk. Talk about interesting stuff. Also, guys, follow me on Twitter at his name, Dev Ramsey. Yeah, I think we're done. Looks good. Thank you guys for joining the stream.